Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Porsche Cayenne and we'll show you how to do front brake pad replacement. All the parts and tools that will be used in the video, including those original Bosch brake pads guys, will be shared in the description of the video below so you can check out where we get ours from. Now we have a video how to replace the rear one as well. That will be a separate video. In the meantime guys, we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe for more videos if you have a car like that. Even if you don't, we're constantly making videos for other cars. So that's what we'll be doing today. Let's go ahead and start on it now. So for the brake pads, we'll demonstrate on the front right. Front left will be pretty much identical procedure guys, so we won't waste time showing you both sides. We have this side in the air, also you have to have a jack stand. Okay, never ever rely on the jack itself, because if it fails, that thing is heavy and it's going to kill you. So that's a very dangerous job, and if you're not qualified, don't have the experience, I wouldn't recommend it. So let's start on it now. So we're ready to remove the wheel now. In the meantime, we're going to paint our bolts today, because you can see how nasty rusty they are. Okay, if it's too noisy guys, we will apologize, but it's snowing, icing outside right now, so... Okay, that tire is extremely heavy now, so you have to be careful. You have to always hold it, don't just kick it. Okay, you have to like gently pull it out, not to drop on the caliper, because if it drops on the caliper, it can damage something up. Okay, just like that. Okay, so next we're going to turn the steering wheel to the right. Okay, perfect, so we can access everything a little bit better. So first thing, our brake sensors are still good, so we are not going to replace those. Okay, we're going to pull them out gently. Hopefully we don't damage them in the meantime. We have a video how to brake past those, to bypass them, and how to replace them if you need to, but... Okay, those are the two brake wear sensors on this side, so we remove those now. So now we're going to get a screwdriver guys. Okay, I'll recommend to use the correct tools and all that stuff, and with the screwdriver, okay, we're going to compress the caliper that way. Okay, we're going to get a second screwdriver in a little bit, because this is a 6-piston caliper, Brembo caliper, and you have to have special tools to compress all 6 pistons at the same time. So we're going to use one more screwdriver here now. You have to be extremely careful. If you damage one of the pistons and the seals, your brakes might fail. So consider these guys entertaining video and not a how-to video. So do not follow what you do. We're going to show you how we do it. Okay, that doesn't mean that this is the correct way to do things. Okay, now the one on the other side. Now, we're going to remove the brake roller as well, because we need to have ours resurfaced. They're going to cut the top layer off of it, and that way we'll not have any brake pulsation as well. So after all 6 pistons are compressed, we're going to use a 13mm, okay, to get that bolt loose there. Okay, perfect, just like that. So we installed the bolt almost all the way in, and we're gently, super gently going to tap, okay, so it can break the rust and brake dust loose there, and then we'll remove it. If you do not screw the bolt all the way in, you're going to damage the thread, and as a result, you have to replace it later. Okay, now, it's recommended all the bolts to be replaced every time you do a brake job. That's a must. That's what the manual says usually. Okay, you can see we have a little bit of rust there. Okay, that's all. Now, don't lose the parts. We're going to pull the pads out. Okay. You can see those are pretty much wore out all the way. So we need a 5mm Allen wrench now. And there is one bracket that we need to remove. Okay, let me get the camera in. So actually it's a 6mm Allen wrench. Okay, and that bracket is the one that holds the brake line, ABS sensor, and the brake pad wear sensor. Okay, we're going to get this one loose. After that we have some wire, or we have to have extremely heavy duty zip ties, because we will need to tie the brake caliper, okay, to the shock. This is the ball that we removed. Now the bracket, let's see if it's going to be able to move some. Okay, we have to remove the hose, the wiring harness from there. Okay, and that should give us some slack so we can pull the brake caliper out in a little bit, so we can remove the roller. Okay, perfect. So in our case there are 21mm bolts right here now that we need to remove. So we need to get this one loose. Okay, and also extremely tight. Okay, this one is getting there. You have to be extremely careful not to damage your brake line here. Okay, now let's try the top one to see how we're going to fit behind the brake line. Okay, and okay, we got loose. You have to be careful when the okay wrench slips not to break your boot here. Okay, one of the bolts is about to come out, perfect. Now the bottom one. Okay, great. This one came out as well. Okay, now we'll gently just pull it to the side and we're going to tie it. Okay, careful not to damage any brake lines, cables, anything like that, guys. You have to be extremely careful. Okay, we're going to tie it really good so it doesn't drop, and we're almost to the roller part, and we can go ahead and remove now. Now we need Torx 50. Again, guys, all the tools and parts will be listed in the description of the video below, and we need to go ahead and remove that bolt. Just take it off all the way. Okay. And now the roller, we'll have to gently tap it, and we might even spray some WD-40 or penetrating oil here if we need to, so it can break loose. Okay, WD-40 penetrating oil here, just a little bit. I'm going to move it, but it's in park, so I will not be able to. We will gently tap it and see if it's going to come out. coming out, but now the thing about it is, okay, let me spray a little bit more here. Okay, perfect. All that rest deposit later you have to cleanse before you install the rotor. Okay, and you can see it's right here. So that'll be now, you install a new rotor, or we'll take ours to the machine shop, they'll cut the top layer, make it nice and even, and remove that glass finish on it, that way we'll not have any brake pulsation. So we'll come back in just a little bit and show you the results. So now we're going to clean where the rotor contacts the hub. Okay, we got the new brake rotor, not the new one, the old one, resurfaced, that looks kind of like, you know. Look how nice and smooth it is. Use very, very inexpensive procedure, and that's the correct way to go. Otherwise, if it's too thin, go ahead and buy new rotors as well, guys. So we're going to clean that rust there. That way the roller will slide right in. Now we need to find a little bolt right here with the Torx 50, and we're going to get the roller on. Start the bolt. Okay, let me start it quick here. We need to turn left a little up, too much. Okay, right there. We just need to make sure that it's started, yep. We're going to tap on it. Okay, to make sure that it's in. I'll recommend to use a plastic rubber hammer when you do that. Perfect. Now go ahead and turn the steering wheel to the right so we have more room to work with. We're going to clean the glides where the brake pads contact there a little bit, just with very fine sandpaper, just to clean the rust deposit and the brake grease deposits as well. A little bit of cleaning WD-40. Okay, perfect. You have to be careful not to drop it like what we did here, because you can damage your lines like that and sensors, so don't do that. Now we're going to get the two bolts. Those two bolts, you have to buy and install new bolts every time you put it together. Okay, you cannot reuse your bolts. In our case, we are, but you're not supposed to. Again, consider that video more like an entertaining video than a how-to video, because some of the procedures that we follow are not the correct ones. Perfect. Okay, let's go ahead. Place the roller on top of the caliper on top of the roller. Now we're going to install the two bolts quick, and we'll come back. So we started them by hand. We'll just use the little impact, it doesn't have much torque. Okay, we'll do the top one now. Perfect. And now we're going to get the torque wrench. Now, what I found, you always have to double check that, check your service manual, call your dealership, because those could differ. Now, for ours, the torque specs, guys, for those bolts, actually, okay, it says 200 foot per pound or 270 newton meter, 270, that's enormous amount of torque. So we have the torque wrench, okay, right here. I have it set at 200 feet per pound, okay, and we're going to go ahead, okay, get it tight now until we hear the click and don't go more, but make sure that you follow the torque specs that you need. Out of this, again, 200 feet per pound, 270 newton meter. Okay. Okay, perfect. Just like that. Now we're going to install the little bolt with the bracket that holds the brake line. In our case, the ABS sensor there and the brake wear sensor too. So that's what we're doing now. We'll get it tight. Okay, we're just getting it tight now. Perfect. Okay, just like that. So as you can see on the old brake pads, we have brake grease on the back side where the caliper, the pistons contact the brake pad. That's what we'll be doing. Also on the new ones, we're going to apply a very thin amount here. That's where it contacts the caliper on the lower point. Okay, so let's squeeze some out. This is the package that comes with it, Bosch brake pad grease, super quiet brakes that way. Okay, very thin amount there, perfect. And we can slide this one in just a minute. Let's get the second one. We'll do absolutely the same thing to it. Okay, great. Okay, we'll push the pad in. Now the second one. Okay, just like that. Now we need to clean that bolt. We soaked it earlier. Now just a little bit of sandpaper, fine one, to clean all the dust, rust deposit. This bolt should be, you should use a new one every time you remove it as well, every time you put brake pads. Don't ask why, we are not. A little bit of brake grease on the bolt as well. Okay, very thin amount. Perfect. Now we need to get the metal plate. Okay, and this metal plate will actually, it should go, okay, let me see, now it will go this way. Because the cable will come from this side, it will go through here and come down then later. So now one person needs to, okay, let me see if I can hold it down a little bit, yep. Okay, now we need to move that plate a little bit. It's going to get loose once we align the bolt, you see. Perfect. Now, let's get the bolt in, and when it comes to that lower spot, Okay. Okay, the plate came. Make sure that here it goes in the canal like it's supposed to. Okay, so everything looks good here. We need to install the bolt. The torque specs for this one could differ as well. We'll try to list some of them in the description of the video. You can also find online, and when we find more information, we'll make a special video for the torque specs for all the bolts, guys. So far, we on our model, we found for the ones for the back side. Okay, perfect. That's it, right there. Now, we need to get the brake pad wear sensor. Okay, you need to go through the bleeder seal right there. Go like that. That's how ours was before we took it apart. Okay, now. Okay, let's see exactly how it was. Here, we need to go like that. Push in. A little bit, it gets stuck. Okay, perfect. This one is in all the way. Now we need to go under here. And we need to install the brake pad wear sensor on this side. Okay, it went in just to make sure. Okay, let's push it one time. We need to get it in the canal here. Okay. And make sure that you get your wire if you had one from the strap. Just like that. Now, something very important that we have to do, stay with us to make sure that you follow that procedure. Now, one person needs to go inside the car, do not start it yet. And you need to press the brake pedal hard as much as you can. I would say probably 20 times, even more, until you feel the brake pedal really hard all the way up. Because now we have play in the calipers, and if you hit the brakes a few times, you're not going to have brakes at first. Okay, watch out how we took the play. So you can see now it's contacting, so we're ready to go. So we got our wheel tight. You can check out on our channel. Okay, we have the video for the wheel torque specs. So that's how we replace the brake pads, guys, on our Cayenne. Hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button, guys, for more videos, and see you next time.